one of the favorite haunts of Axl Rose, should you ever be in town and care. As you know, the guys are all out on tour right now with a much more powerful sound than previously, thanks mainly to new members Dizzy Reed on keyboards and Matt Sorum, formerly of The Cult, on drums. Let's find out what they had to say about one another.
Originally, I was just going to go in and do the record and then go back to The Cult and stay with The Cult. And then as soon as a couple weeks of rehearsals went by, I went to a barbecue at Glass and he proposed a question to me. Do you want to join Guns N' Roses? You know? I kind of went, well, can I have a cocktail, please? Can I?
Well, Matt's really solid, you know, and you can, everybody in the band can rely on Matt's playing. You know, it's, you know, the drums are like your anchor, and he's definitely the strongest anchor we've ever had, and one of the best drummers that there are, I think, in the world.
You know, I got used to working with Matt like that, and then Dizzy came in, and it was just piano, which I'm used to listening to anyway, with whatever other bands it is that I'm listening to.
To me, it's just as anything else, I just looked at it as another challenge. And it's like, if I can pull this off, I can definitely do anything.
Child of Mine. As you know, they are out on tour right now. Here are some tour dates. No matter how many times you may have caught them in the past, they're definitely worth catching again right now, believe me. We're going to take some time here in the Scrap Bar, one of Guns N' Roses' favorite night spots in New York City whenever they're in town. But we will be right back with a look at their new stage show and a talk with some of their fans and their new pal, Arnold Schwarzenegger. So don't go away.
You asked for them. Next weekend, you'll get them. It's Power Pack Weekend. We pack two.
Here's one of the most famous music stores in the United States, Manny's on 48th Street in New York City. Welcome back to Blown Away. Back in 1988, Guns N' Roses filmed part of their Paradise City video here. And of course, they've been threatening to release a new album ever since then. Those two new records are due out any moment now, as always. And if you've been wondering what's been holding them up, well, I think we have a few answers for you. Let's take a listen.
That's taken a long and made it take a long time. I mean, it was success, you know, made it take a long time. That sudden realization of like being huge blew my mind. It threw me for a loop, right? Especially because we were sort of like just not from that school at all. So that took a little while. I mean, that took till just recently for me to adjust to, just as far as home life goes. And then there was the associated drug problems that you know ensued, and then there was you know, the situation with Steven, and then finding somebody to replace Steven, and you know, finding somebody to fit into the band.
After this comes out, there'll be an EP of six punk rock songs coming out, and we're already starting to work on new material now with an 8-track on the road, and hopefully, you know, we can fire something out by the end of this rather than wait forever.
Well, there you go, a virtual avalanche of Guns N' Roses albums coming your way soon, at least according to Axl Rose. Right now we're in New Jersey outside a giant stadium not far from New York City, where back in 1988, Guns N' Roses were the opening act on a show by Aerosmith and Deep Purple. Those days, of course, are far behind them. Nowadays, Guns N' Roses are certified headliners. This is a little strange when you think about it, because up until now, the band has only released one full-fledged album. Nevertheless, everybody that goes to see this group live seems to come away loving them. And as we discovered recently, the guys in Guns N' Roses love the fans right back.
I appreciate it because it makes me feel like part of the game.
I love hanging out with the fans, you know? I mean, without them, we would do this, you know?
They're artistic, you know? They're in their own world.
They don't care what anyone thinks. They don't care about anyone. They do their own thing.
They're kind of rebels, so, you know, we kind of dig them pretty much.
We totally idolize Slash as a guitarist. I have the same kind of guitarist, Slash.
I love their attitude. I love Axl Rose. He's my idol. I grew up to be Axl Rose.
Why is Axl Rose awesome?
Look at the guy. Just look at the guy.
The most notorious band in the world.
In the world.
Why in the world?
Worldwide.
Worldwide.
And I have to usually somewhat keep it a bit controlled and stuff so things don't get crazy and stuff. But, you know, I was out signing autographs and talking to people tonight.
I've always been the type to take the time out to talk to people. It's like when it comes down to it, that's where we're happening, is with the people that we're playing for.
Of people that are just worried about being rock stars or individual rock stars in bands, there's a lot of, with Guns N' Roses fans, there's a lot of Axl, but it's like, this is a band and I wouldn't be able to do what I do the way I do it and wouldn't be able to get the recognition if I didn't have the band I have being supportive and playing the music that they play that makes me run around and stuff. We all pretty much get off on each other a lot. So it's definitely a band thing.
Welcome back to Blown Away. Right now we're outside the backstage entrance to the Ritz in New York City, where last spring Guns N' Roses played a special pre-tour surprise performance and also picked up some footage for the video for You Could Be Mine, a song featured on the soundtrack of Terminator 2. Making that video, of course, also allowed them to meet one of their idols, Arnold Schwarzenegger. Take a look.
They have been big, big fans of Terminator and have expressed it many times, and so... I have been a fan of their music, so we checked into what it would be like to do a video together or to get some of their music.
What worked out really cool is we wanted to put out a version of the song, You Could Be Mine. We shot a video for it. We filmed the show in the Ritz, and then, I guess Arnold was flying back from Congress. I'm going, I want to be in the video.
We hung out really, we got along really, really well. And he gave the whole band jackets from the movie, and these great French leather biker jackets, right? With bullet holes everywhere.
No problemo.
Really cool. We're kind of real soft-spoken. Nice guy.
Hasta la vista, baby.
We shot some footage of us coming out of the dressing room, the stage door at the Roxy in L.A., where we come face to face with Arnold in his Terminator gear, and it was all pretty funny, and
whoa.
Pretty rotted by that point.
Welcome back to Blown Away. As you know, Guns N' Roses are out on tour right now, and just like the Rolling Stones and Led Zeppelin 20 years ago, they seem to be stirring up controversy and uproar wherever they go, most recently at a riot in St. Louis in early July. In case you haven't caught any of their shows this time around, we do have a quick sampler for you right now, and here it is.
Ever since we started, we've been aiming at, being, we wanted our second major album, we wanted to headline and what I think vocally I can do best.
Our shows, we never had a perfect show. Like a lot of bands, I will say names or whatever, they have the set list and say the same thing in these songs every night. This is going to a 9-to-5 job for me.
Now I get up around whenever. I used to get up on time. That old man, he's a real muscle. He's gonna get it on time.
The first live show with Guns N' Roses was Rock in Rio.
What was that like?
It was like a blur. I was like, man, I can't believe this. I would be like completely lying and ridiculous if I said I wasn't nervous for that.
Touring on our own merit, so to speak. And the record comes out, it'll take whatever it is we're doing now that much further. But at the same time, we're out there and doing it just as a band.
I cut sex from it.
I peed in my pants.
As you might imagine from that, this is a tour you really should catch. And if you haven't done so yet, here are some tour dates. Back here at the Scrap Bar on McDougal Street in New York City's Greenwich Village, a big Guns N' Roses hangout, where I think I'm going to try one of the house specialties. Have you got that Slash drink here that he... Oh,